Ben from Snows today, folks, with the companion single zone 60 litre lithium rechargeable fridge freezer. Hit it. This is an ultimately portable fridge freezer with a built-in battery pack that means you're not tied to having to plug it into a vehicle or a 240 volt power supply to take it in and out of your campsite or even to the picnic on the weekend. We'll start off with the weights and dimensions. It's 27 kilos for the whole fridge, including the built-in battery pack that we'll go into shortly. And dimension wise, from the very furthest points on each end, the handles are sort of flush here. It's 82 centimeters in length. Just over 46 centimeters in depth, 48 centimeters in depth, and it's 46 centimeters in height. The body is all this sort of textured polypropylene, so it's a lightweight but strong body, and it's all the same material. Sides and top is all this same sort of flexible, well, not flexible, but this durable polypropylene. I'm doing a bit of a tour around the outside. The top here, just the lid with a couple of little sort of drink holders here, so you can put your drink on there without it sliding off. We're gonna go into this shortly. There's a battery compartment under there. Won't go into that just yet. We'll go down on the front here. Handle on one side of the lid here, nothing more to see there. Vents on the side of the compressor there, and above that is a bottle opener. If we jump down to the other end of the fridge here, we have got the control panel, go into that shortly. The handle that we mentioned before that sits nice and flush, so you don't need to remove them if you're trying to save space inside the vehicle. And below that, you've got an Anderson input output port and also a 12 and 24 volt input port with a fuse there. Flicking it around to the back, not much to see, except that you've got a handle on the other side of the lid. It's a reversible lid. Bottom corner here, vent where the compressor sits, and above that you've got another bottle opener, so a bottle opener on each side of the fridge. And if we spin it around to this end here, this is a heavier end because we've got the compressor and a battery in here. So at the top here is a lithium battery in this compartment, and we'll go into that shortly. Another spring-loaded handle here, the vent where the compressor sits, and you've got another Anderson input output, and a 12 and 240 volt port here. Now I'm gonna go into all the power options for this guy a little bit later in the video, because there's a bit to consider and a few different options there. But what I wanna do first is show you inside the fridge and how to use it. So as I mentioned, this lid is, it hinges both ways. So there's a latch here that also hinges the other way and comes off completely. So don't have to change any hinges or anything for that to happen. The lid automatically hinges whichever way you've got it placed into your vehicle. Inside the unit here, single unit, you've got in width about 50 centimeters, about 34 centimeters in depth this way, and about 33 centimeters in height, and that's rough. It's sort of trying to allow for this little sort of bit that dips down into the space here. There is a seal that runs around the edge of the fridge here. It's a rubber seal that runs right around the edge, and that teams up with the little ridge that sits on top of the base here, so it seals nicely to keep that cold air inside the fridge. There's a removable basket in here, so the dimensions that I gave you for inside the fridge, you need to remove a little bit from what I mentioned, and it does kind of slope in a little bit at the base here, so you've got probably 4 centimeters in from the edge here. So what the width you've got at the top is not quite the width you've got at the base, but this is removable to make the easy cleaning. So I'm gonna take that out, and you can see on the bottom of the fridge here, you've got a little bung that you can remove, easy cleaning. So the water just runs out the bottom of the fridge there to keep it clean. Other features inside are LED light that features up the top here, that if we were to turn it on, which I'll just do quickly now, we can see the LED light comes. So we've got visibility in here in the dark, and flat sides around here, easy to clean, and the cooling units run right around the side of the fridge. Now the height of the internals of this fridge mean you can pretty comfortably fit an upright 1.25 litre soft drink bottle there. There's a champagne bottle there as well, so they fit comfortably upright. The lid does have a lip around here and dips up higher in here, so you've actually got slightly higher in the center of the fridge than that 33 centimeters I mentioned before, but you can comfortably fit upright drink bottles inside there. And before I forget, the insulation on the side is pretty thick on this fridge here. You've got about 6.5 centimeters by my measurements of high grade PU foam insulation around the sides of the fridge here. It's pretty much all the features inside. I want to show you how to use the fridge now. If we jump around to the control panel at the front here. Now I've got, this is going to be running off the internal battery here at the moment. We can plug it into 240 volt or 12 volt DC, which I'll go into shortly. But I just want to show you how to use this panel here. One thing I haven't mentioned is below, just around the corner underneath the panel here, are two USB ports. So you can actually charge phones or devices from this, or run phones and devices from this as well. So just another handy little feature. Now to turn this on, got the power button on the side here, we click that, the display immediately lights up and shows us a few things that are going on. So starting on the top right here, we've got a battery indicator. So that's actually showing us the voltage of the battery inside the fridge, the included battery, which, as I keep mentioning, we'll go into shortly, but that's showing it's half charged at the moment. Below that is the actual voltage of the battery, and it's actually showing that it's kind of flat right now. It needs a charge at 11.4 volts. It's got a maximum state of charge at 12.8 volts. If that was reading 12.8, this little dial here would also show that the battery is fully charged. Just to the left of that, next to the temperature, or below, next to the voltage and below the temperature, is an H. That is an indication of the battery protection level. If we've got it running off a 12 volt power source, it will cut out when the battery reaches a certain point. Your instruction manual will tell you what those cutout voltages are, but to adjust it, we hold down on the power button here until that setting flashes on the display. We can see that flashing there now. If I press this button again, it will scroll between low, medium and high, and if I just let it sit for I think about 5 to 10 seconds, that'll eventually stop flashing and that will then be set. So we can see that's set there now. Now the eco mode, well, there's eco and max. So eco is the compressor running in eco mode. If you press the settings button here once, it flashes. Press it again, that'll change to max, so the compressor will now run in maximum mode. It'll draw more power, but it'll bring the temperature inside the fridge down quicker. But once the temperature inside the fridge has come down, set it back to the eco mode so that you're not drawing all your battery power. Now above that, we've got the temperature that's inside the cabinet. So this is the current temperature inside the cabinet. To change this, we use the plus and minus buttons on the side here. Now this will go anywhere from plus 20 to minus 20 degrees. So I can bring that right down to the minuses there if I want. That will then flash, I'll set it to 0 degrees. It'll flash for a few seconds and then stop flashing, and it goes back to the actual temperature inside the unit. I think I've covered off everything on how to use the fridge and all the features, but what I want to talk about now are the power options, and I'm just going to flick it around here. And as I talk, remember there are both Anderson and 12 and 240 volt inputs on both ends of this fridge here. Now you've got a few different options, or three different power options for this. You get these included cables with your fridge. Firstly, a 240 volt cable here with a transformer. You also get the DC cable here, which plugs into your 12 and 24 volt outlet with a cigarette plug here that can be either a merit or a cigarette plug, and that's connected to the cable with an Anderson plug there. And the last power option you got is with the integrated 42 amp hour lithium NMC battery pack, which is underneath this cover here. So the first thing we do when we open this is we'll see a little sort of just an opening here, or a space here, which is not cooled. It's just a storage space, and it is a good place to keep the cables when you're not using them. They'll fit fairly easily inside there, or perhaps somewhere to store phones or devices. Underneath the rubber base here, if we pull this out, there's a little tab there to pull it out. There is the 42 amp hour lithium battery that I mentioned before, and this lifts out with this handle here. We lift this up, it removes two little locking pins that feature on the back here. We can see them coming in and out to lock it into place. Now we've now got a portable power pack that we can use independently of the fridge. So if we've got this fridge plugged into 240 or 12 volt or 24 volt, it will run without this inside the fridge. It will run purely on 240 volt or 12 volt. If we've got the battery pack inside the fridge, it's going to both run the fridge and power the battery pack. But at any point, if the 240 volt or the 12 volt power is cut off to the fridge, it will revert to running off of this battery pack here. And this guy will give you about 16 hours of run time for this fridge here. So you can literally take it out of your car, no cables attached, take it to your campsite, inside your picnic area, you're not limited by where the vehicle is, run it for the day to keep your drinks and your food cold, put it back in your car at the end of the day and charge it up again. This locks into place. It's got three little Anderson ports here that line up with the Anderson in the bottom there, so that's what connects it all up to the fridge. They don't mention anything about using these ports for actual power from this battery pack, but it does have two little USB ports in the top here, so you can power or charge USB devices from this power pack here. We slide that into place, the fridge beeps when it's locked into place. We just heard that beep then. We can put this back in there, put our storage items in there, close this up, and we're good to go. The fridge is now ready to operate even though it's not plugged in. And back to the cables, we'll just come back down to the power end of the fridge here. Now, both the 240 volt and the 12 volt power cords plug into this port here. There is a little notch in there, so it is directional, so that will only plug in this way. So that's where we power it from, a DC or a 240 volt AC power source. Next to that, we've got our Anderson solar in. Now this is an in and an out. It's a live 12 volt power source at any given point, and it's got the same port at the other end. So you can both have solar coming into this end and also chain fridges together if you like. So your solar can be running two fridges using the power or the Anderson port at the other end there. Now, one interesting thing with the solar is that they say the internal battery has a maximum stator charge of 12.8 volts. And they say that any solar panel that you use, it's going to have a lithium compatible solar controller, but it's also going to need to be limited to 12.8 volts maximum output because the battery inside will cut out at 12.8 volts. Now that can be a bit limiting. Companion's own solar panels have a controller that you can actually change to limit that maximum output to 12.8, but a lot of solar panels that you buy will have a charge profile that will go above that. So you can use existing solar panels, but what you'll find is that if at any point that solar panel's charge level goes above 12.8, you're not gonna damage the battery, but it's gonna cut out and you're gonna have to take the battery out and put it back in to reset it all to keep it running again. So it could be a little bit finicky. I haven't tested just how often that happens. If the compressor's running and the solar panels are on at the same time, it's probably not gonna reach that 12.8. But if it does get to that point, then the battery is going to cut out. So if you are running this purely off of solar, I'd recommend looking at the companion solar panels or one that has an adjustable solar controller. So you can limit it at 12.8 and that way you know you've always got charge going into it. Now, one other thing I did have to clarify with companion around this cable here is if we grab the 12 volt cable and we plug it into our 12-24 volt port there, we've got the cigarette plug on this end here with a merit if we like, but we can also remove this and this now becomes an Anderson port. Now we might think, well, I can just plug my solar panel into here because this 240 volt puts out 14 volts, so obviously the battery's not going to cut out, but that's not going to work because with solar, it needs power both at the solar panel end and the battery end to plug it in. So you could plug your solar panel into this, nothing's going to happen because there's no power here. This Anderson port here has got power. It's a live power setting. So the battery management system inside has got this always connected to the battery. So when you plug your solar panel into here, the power goes back to the solar controller. That's what wakes it up and connects the solar panel to the battery. So plug your solar panel into there if you like. It's not going to work. You're going to have to put your solar panel straight into this port here. So you've got a few different power options here, and those live power or live Anderson ports at each end of the fridge do give you plenty of options with this fridge here to really stay unplugged. You can have your solar panel running this fridge and a second non-battery powered fridge plugged into this end running off the same solar panel if you like, all powered from that battery. So really gives you vehicle or 240 volt power free refrigeration to take just about anywhere you want. Accessories that come with the fridge, I've shown you what you actually get included. There's no fridge slide specifically for this. You'll have to get a fridge slide that sort of fits the dimensions of this and use these handles just to tie it down on the fridge slide if you're going to go down that path. You can get a cover to go over the fridge here. This is an insulated cover that will fit over the top. Works in with all the handles and bottle openers and things, and you've got a couple of pockets on the front there. This is going to give you a little bit more efficiency, a little bit of protection against direct sun, and also protect the outside of the fridge. This fridge or this range of fridges, the lithium fridges from Companion, are really ultimately transportable fridge. If you want something that you want to just charge in your vehicle and then take it out and put it in your campsite for the day, and possibly great for parties or even stalls where you need to keep cold fridges, cold drinks or ice at hand for the day, this allows you to do that without having your vehicle right nearby. They're a really portable option. You can check these out online at snowys.com.au where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest information or check out some other companion products like these ones down here.